What's going on, guys? It's your boy Chili here, bringing you another Lego set review. This time, if you can't tell, I am doing the Infinity Saga Infinity Gauntlet. It's in the 18 plus category. It's set number 76191, and it's 590 pieces. I'm sure you've probably seen, you know, other YouTubers, especially bigger YouTubers, do the Infinity Gauntlet. I mean, heck, I've even seen some do the Nano Gauntlet, and, you know, comes out on the first for us plebs that aren't in, you know, LAN or have friends overseas. But I wanted to get this after I got, my last video, if you haven't seen it, go check it out. It's Thor's hammer or Mjolnir, and really liked that. And I was like, you know what, I might as well get, you know, the most, like, powerful object in the universe. And I wanted to pick up the Infinity Gauntlet. I actually found this one hidden behind a bunch of stuff at Walmart. And as soon as I picked it up, I looked down the rest of the aisle, and there was one actually sitting out, like chest level shelf. And I dug all the way behind, like, a whole bunch of other, like, Lego sets to get this one, because I found it, like, stuffed behind a bunch of stuff, like it was hidden. And yeah, it made me kind of feel dumb that I didn't just, you know, look. I instantly gravitated to the one that I couldn't get. But I ended up getting it, and that's the one I brought home. Like, not a lot of box damage to this one, even though I did get it from Walmart. I wanted to say I saw a dent on it somewhere right here. There's, like, a little mark. Thought I saw a dent on it somewhere, but maybe this was the better of the two boxes. Who knows? I didn't really check out the other one, because after that, I was a little pissed off at myself, to be honest, that I didn't just look. I mean, it was literally like a shelf away, too. It's not like it was, you know, all the way down at the other end of the aisle. It was right there with the rest of the Marvel sets. You know, I don't know how they do it at other Walmarts, but at ours, it split up Star Wars, like, creator sets, Harry Potter, and then on the other side of the aisle, it's Marvel and Ninjago and DC, I think is how that goes. But either way, wanted to pick this up, so I picked it up. It cost me like $70, even though Walmart.com says it's on sale right now for $65, but I was about to argue the $5. Plus, I picked up another set that said it was like almost $40, and it ended up only being $21. So I kind of got the savings on this anyway, if you think about it in that way. I paid full price for the other thing, or however you want to do it. Just subtract it. It makes sense in my head. But this box, like I said, 18 plus categories. So you're going to have the all black. You have the Infinity Saga, Infinity Gauntlet logo with the Infinity Gauntlet, you know, prominently on the front of the box. Lego and Marvel logos as well. And you can see it does come with a little display plaque. It's got this gold like hue around it, which looks really good against that black box, like the little aura, however you want to say it, that's like around it. You can see all the Infinity Stones are in the gauntlet. This part looks kind of weird. We'll see what that's all about when I get into building it. But yeah, I mean, it's got the black little brickwork down here. Looks really good. Sure, that continues over to the sides as well. Moving to the side, you're gonna have the Infinity Saga, and then a whole different language I'm not gonna try to pronounce it. You have the components and where they were made, telling, you know, set that's made for 18 plus, not to choke on the parts. So yeah, if you're 18 years or older, don't eat Lego parts, I guess. Like, that's what Lego has to tell you. Down at the bottom, you are going to see it's a 2021 set. So again, I'm late to the game, but I just wanted to pick this one up after I got Thor's hammer. Thought it was a cool build on that. Wanted to see how this one was. But you got your barcode, item number, you know, all that good stuff. Like, nothing real important at the bottom other than if you want to know the date. The side of the box, you're going to have another Lego Marvel logo with the Infinity Gauntlet with the hands stretched out, kind of how they are on the front, but just a more front view, I guess. with the display stand, some more of that black brickwork. On the back of the box, you're going to see the infamous snap displayed. So that's really cool. Down here, it tells you that it's 12 and a half inches tall. Does not tell you how wide it is. And then you've got like some, you know, stuff from the movies. Thanos holding an Infinity Stone with some planets and stuff in the background. And then Thanos just with the Infinity Gauntlet, like looking like Thanos. It does have thumb tabs. Can't believe that for this set, but it does. With more of that black Griebling. The top of the box, if I turn it around the right way, has like a little Nexo Knight shield with the actual size and then in gold. And then the Infinity Saga logo in a different language with Marvel Studios and the Lego logo. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much it on the box. Like, I mean, I can't, it's all black. There's not like a scenery in the background to like, you know, talk about. It does look absolutely dope. I can't wait to set this up next to my Thor's hammer. So I'm going to get to building it. Actually, you can still see like the extra parts from Thor's hammer over here, like all the Infinity Stones. I forgot to put those away before I started recording this, but there's the extra parts for Thor's hammer if you watched that video. But I'm going to get into this, get it built, set it up next to my Thor's hammer, see what it looks like compared to that, and then I'll probably record the review video, so I'll have to move it back over to this table. But I will see y'all when we get back. Almost forgot to open it, guys. Like, y'all weren't going to tell me? Weren't going to tell me. Like, I done got, like, my phone moved. I gotten, you know, YouTube videos set up to play in the background while I built. Nobody was going to tell me that I forgot to open it for them. Well, let's get my knife out here so I can cut these thumb tabs, because I don't like thumb tabs, especially on sets for adults. Like, maybe for kids that might not care about the box. I mean, I guess some adults don't really care about the box either, right? But me, I kind of like keeping my more, you know, adult-themed boxes. Like, if I buy, like, a kid set or something, I don't keep it. But either way, dang, I know I just opened this. Did I not do it good enough? I might not have done it good enough. Don't rip the box. Don't rip the box. And there is your full box of contents, which is not that many bags. If I have to be real, it is three whole bags. Three whole bags. Here's your instruction. You got that same box art from the front. Feedback to win on the back. It's going to have some stuff about the creator there, so if you want to pause and read that, and there's your different languages, some nice little artwork of Thanos, like really cool little book for this. Again, you've got three bags. You start off building like that little stand. Here's your inventory sheet, which, you know, doesn't have a lot of pieces. Guess I was expecting more like bags. You're finished when you put on the last two Infinity Stones, which Time Stone and the Mind Stone, I believe, is the one in the middle. I'm quite positive it's the one in the middle. Yeah. Yep, it is. All right. Because it's the Soul Stone, the Reality Stone, the, what is it, like Space Stone or something like that. I can't remember what one of them is. I have to look that up. And then the Power Stone. And so those two would be the Time and the Mind. So that's where it finishes, 148, page 97. Not a very big build. Might end up building a couple of things tonight to go ahead and get videos out for. But now that I remembered to do the unboxing, I'm now going to get into this build. So I will see you when we get back. We are back. As you can see, I have finished the Infinity Gauntlet. Really neat build. kind of not as tall as I think I was anticipating it to be, but it still looks really good. As you can see, like, all the gold is super reflective. It looks so good. I can't, like, I've actually watched a review already on the Nano Gauntlet, and from what I've seen, this looks so much better than the Nano Gauntlet, but I'm still probably going to pick up the Nano Gauntlet just because I have this one now. I have Thor's hammer. Might as well get the Nano Gauntlet to finish off, you know, the three, like weapons, I guess you can call it, weapon builds, since I guess this technically is kind of like a weapon. But yeah, just look at this thing. Like, it looks incredible. Now, it is on the, like, black, like, helmet type stand with the Infinity Saga Infinity Gauntlet with the Lego logo. Now, flipping this over, as you can see, you can't put your actual hand in it. Like, I don't know who actually thinks you can, but just letting you know, you can't. It is built into the stand. And I guess if you really wanted to, you could build it without the stand so that it's more, you know, like, without it. I don't know why you would want to, but you can do that if you want. This gold, though, like, I know I've already mentioned it, but just look at how, like, nice these gold pieces, like, just look. They're so shiny. Like, you can tell the tan here, but they just look so good on this. Like, really nice, really nice all the way around. The palm is more, I think I messed this piece up. But I'll fix that later. But yeah, it just looks so good. Like, I really like this. I really like Thor's hammer. I feel like the Marvel sets are just knocking it out of the water compared to the Star Wars sets. I don't really understand why. I figured Star Wars would be more popular, but the Marvel sets just look so much better. Like, so much better detail in them, in the minifigures, in the actual, like, builds. They look so much better than the Star Wars ones. But, you know, and then they get the actual printed pieces on all their stuff, is where Star Wars gets, you know, stickers. But anyway, going back to the build, all these fingers are posable, as you would probably guess. Like, I showed y'all the back of the box, you can make it snap, you can put all the fingers down like so. The thumb is on a little ball joint right there. I think you can see that pretty good. There you go. On a little ball joint, so it's got a little bit more motion than the other fingers, but you can still put it into, like, a well, that's a horrible looking fist, but you can still put it into a fist. I don't know if I messed up on the pinky or if it's supposed to be that high, but it just seems like it's a lot higher. Like, if you make a fist, your pinky kind of sits below your ring finger, that, you know, first knuckle, and the first knuckle of this sits higher than the ring finger. So I'm not really, you know, sure why. Maybe I messed up, maybe that's just the way the build is. Not too sure about that, but either way, you can do, you know, the famous, like they showed on the back of the box, you can do the snap, and I think they have these fingers, like, down, but they have this one kind of up and bent. So you can do the famous snap and, you know, wipe out half of all living creatures in the universe. These pieces aren't really, they move, but they're not meant to move. They're supposed to, like, make it look a little bit thicker around the sides coming into, you know, this little design here. Looks really good. All the Infinity Stones do come out. I'm going to apologize now because I think that I'm getting one of the names of the stones wrong. I think it's the Soul Stone, Reality, Space Power. I think one's Space Power, Mind, and Time. But they all do pop out. They're actually rather simple. They just kind of pop right on off. These are on these little one studs, so they're really easy to pop off. So you just pull every single one of them off. And there you go. There's what it, that's what it looks like without any of the stones on it. And this one here, is a little bit more difficult to get off, but I will try for the purposes of this video. It's like I can't get my hand around it because it's, you know, on a round stud. So I cannot get this off like this. I just can't get my hand around it. So you can pull that whole little thing off and then you just kind of pop that off and just really you can just stick that back on. But why would you want to display this without the Infinity Stones? I have no idea. But there you go. All the stones are popped off. Straightened back up the fingers so that y'all can see. Really simple. And then to pop them back on, super simple as well. You just pop them back right in that same little spot. Fingers can be up. Fingers can be down. It does not really matter. It just, it's a really neat little build. Like, I'd have to say, like, I kind of steer away from, like, the helmet builds. I do have one helmet build of Venom that I got to do a review on. But that's just because Venom's, like, my favorite, like, comic book villain slash anti-hero. Like, I know, like, especially in today's time, like, everybody's all hyped up on Deadpool. But I don't, I mean, Deadpool's cool and all, but I always liked Venom. My favorite. But I usually stay away from builds like this, but I am so glad that I picked this one up. I absolutely like it. It's going to look really good sitting next to my my Thor's hammer. Like I said, I think I messed this part right here up. So we'll fix it on camera. I think it's supposed to, you know, be in line with all the others, but then that kind of looks weird. Maybe I put this on backwards. I'm going to have to check that out after this video because it does look weird, right? Like, all the fingers kind of have their, like, they're all, like, in the same spot, all these little circular pieces without any extra deal here. And then this one's got this extra deal here, and I had it up there, and I feel like I built it right, but it just does not look right. It looks kind of weird like that, but like I said, I probably built that wrong. I'll have to go back and check, but yeah, this thing is, like, really, really cool, and of course, that's more like for the thumb, that piece here. It kind of sticks out kind of a bit. Like if I pull this back, see, it kind of sticks out. This moves, but it's not really supposed to. And there you go. There's your Infinity Gauntlet. Like, again, really cool build. I believe I was looking on Lego.com this morning because I'm planning on making a trip to the Lego store sometime between tomorrow and Thursday. It just depends on what I've got going on in between those. Well, by the time y'all see this video, it'll be, what, Friday? So, today is actually is Monday for me. So, I'm either planning on going today or it'll be Thursday. It's either going to be Monday or Thursday. So, but, and I plan on picking up, like, the Groot and all that. But I was looking at their website and it looks like the price of this went up. I got it at Walmart for $70. And if you try to buy it right now on Lego.com, I think the price went up to $75. If I'm not mistaken, like, don't quote me on that. Maybe I'll put a picture in of, like, the Lego website somewhere over here or down here or somewhere to let you see that that's what it's sitting at right now. I know they did, like, I was planning on getting, like, the Daily Bugle. That went up to $350 from $300. So now I might just pick up the Sanctum Sanctorum instead and call it a day on that. Because the prices are starting to get a little ridiculous. Like, this being, like, $70 to start out with, like, it's only, what, 590 pieces? It should have been the same price as most of the helmets at, you know, $60 at the most. So Lego's starting to, you know, gouge out their prices, and I just broke a piece off. But we'll see. I mean, I don't know. Maybe there's just an error in their website, but we'll see what happens. But anyway, guys, I'm going to call this one done. You've seen the gauntlet. There's not a lot to talk about. It looks like a hand. Feels kind of weird to, like, mess with, like, fingers. Like, it's like, I don't know, like some medical type dummy that you got to mess with his fingers or something. But you've seen it. It looks really good. I couldn't be more happy with it. Can't wait to set it up, you know, after this video with my Thor's hammer or Mjolnir. So yeah, I'm going to call this one done. And if you enjoy this video, as always, smash that like button. Consider subscribing. I really appreciate y'all watching and, you know, making my channel grow from, like, my wife being my only subscriber to having almost 50 now. Like, that's kind of amazing for me to... I really thought that I wouldn't get any subscribers or maybe onesie twosies, but now I'm almost at 50. So, that's always awesome. I appreciate y'all's support of the channel. And... like I said, like the video, consider subscribing if you're new to the channel. Hit the little notification bell if you want notifications on when I post videos, which I post videos every Sunday, Wednesday, and Friday. So at 7 a.m., I just do it at 7 a.m. because I'm on night shift schedule. So I usually go to bed around 7 a.m. So I schedule them to come out at 7 a.m. so that I can have everything done before I go to bed and don't really have to worry about it. But I'm going to get out of here and I will catch you on the next one.